Okay, we're gonna get started. First, I would like to introduce Mr. Drew Lentz. As an entrepreneur, Mr. Lentz has built a successful technology consulting firm, expanded to manufacturing products to enhance the wireless industry, and led teams to success in the industry. As a community advocate for technology, he is the interim president and co-founder of the largest tech nonprofit in South Texas, focused on teaching essentials of computer science, combined with his role as the executive director of the South Texas Community Arts Foundation, responsible for the TED events in the South Texas market, and homeroom dad at his daughter's school. He is elated to show off ways to integrate tech into working, learning, and playing on a daily basis. Let's give him a round of applause.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Did you guys have fun? You guys having fun so far? Chick-fil-A was pretty dope. I was into that. I grabbed two. No one's gonna tell me not to. I'm 6'5". So I have big pictures and stuff to go behind this, and so I'm gonna jump into it. First, I appreciate you guys being here. This is a phenomenal thing. As a community organizer and as an event organizer in the Rio Grande Valley, it's absolutely fantastic to see other people doing this. You know, there's so few community events that are well organized and well put together. And you know, you guys probably aren't there yet that you can appreciate how few of them there are, but as you get older, these things tend to matter a little bit. So my name's Drew. I've been a resident of Valley, grew up in Mercedes, went to school in Mercedes, Mission, Alton, McAllen, a couple different places here and there, but I am local, I'm completely local. This is my beautiful family, some of them. There's an 18-year-old that's supposed to be over here, but he's not in the picture because 18-year-olds don't like to get their picture taken. So I'm father of five. This guy was actually inside this tummy when this picture was taken, but now he's out, so that's kind of cool. That's pretty neat. So I've got five little kids that I've tried to raise in the Rio Grande Valley, 18, 14, 12, 5, and 4 months, 5 months now. So so it's a lot of fun, man. I'll tell you that being a parent is awesome, even when your kids talk back to you and do crazy stuff. It's a lot of fun. So what I'm going to talk about today may or may not have anything to do with technology. You know, what I did is I tried to figure out a way that I could talk to you guys about something that was pretty cool. You know, I've done a lot of really neat stuff in the Valley that I'm really, really proud of, but I didn't want to make this a slideshow about how awesome I am and all the awesome stuff I've done, because no one wants to hear that. It's just super boring. Instead, I want to talk about you guys, right? And if anyone has ever told you, everyone is different. Everyone has something completely different about them. Everyone is just like a snowflake, right? Everyone has something, you know, no two snowflakes are the same, no two people are the same. So I want you guys to do me a favor. Everyone has a phone, I'm assuming. Grab your phone. And I want you to fire up your camera and turn it around so it looks right at your mug, and it'll look something like that. All right? So everyone look at yourself, just for a second. Just look, pretend you're talking to yourself. Everyone on the count of three, we're all gonna say hi. You guys ready? Say hi to yourself. One, two, three.
Hi.
It's weird, right? Everyone take a picture. Smile. Yee. Okay. Tweet it. Put it out there. Come on, this will be a lot of fun.
I don't have to.
Put it out there. Put it on Instagram, put it on Snapchat. Just take a second and put it out there and hashtag STXi Fest. Because apparently I'm the only one that's tweeting, so. This place could, and the importance of social media I can't compel you guys to use social media correctly. And you know what I mean by that, right? Stay away from perverts, stay away from people asking for naked photos of yourselves, don't do any stupid stuff, but we'll talk about that later. Everyone tweet that out real quick and put that hashtag. It's super cool. This event needs more coverage. Now, as soon as you're done with that, don't forget to look up. And by don't forget to look up, I mean in life. Don't forget to look up. Don't forget to put your phone down and realize that there's a world happening all around you. You guys, your age group has some crazy statistics about how often you do this. You guys sit there and stare at your phones. I'm guilty of it too, right? Even though I'm a little older, I try and be cool and stare at my phone as much as I can. Do you realize that in a report that came out last year, you stare at your phone for 87 hours a month? 87 hours. 14 to 32 year olds spend that much time staring at their phone screen. That's one whole week if you take apart sleeping, because you sleep no matter what. If I told you, I want you to do nothing but stare at your phone for an entire week, just stare at it, that'd be kind of crazy, right? But we gladly do that. Everyone gladly does that. You guys gladly do that. So take a chance to look up. because there's an entire world around you where you can have a conversation with an actual human being. And when you have conversations with actual human beings, you'll be amazed at the kind of stuff that happens. Do you guys know who Deadmau5 is? Yes. He sucks. And let me tell you why. This is going on the internet. Awesome. Because he came down here to play a concert with a friend of mine. And when he went to dinner at Costa Mesa with this tour manager, and he sat across the table from the guy, what do you think he did for an hour and a half? He stared at his phone. He didn't look up, he didn't talk to the waitress, he didn't talk to the person across the table from him, he didn't interact with anyone. He sent his orders in through his tour manager talked to the waitress, and he spent the whole time on his phone. That's what Deadmau5 did, the entire time. How is that any way to interact with human beings, man? That's not cool, right? There's something missing in today's society, and this isn't like old man Drew talking to young millennials. Dude, this just sucks, man. Like, interact with people. You'll be surprised at what you can do and what you can accomplish when you actually have a conversation with a human being. The next thing I want to ask you guys to do is find yourself before you find someone else. And this is one of those things that every parent thinks and no parent really wants to say. It's something that your dad has probably told you in jest, but he's being serious. And that's don't get married before you're 30. and it's kind of funny, but there's some reality there. Did you know that if you if you change your status every 5 seconds, everyone finds that to be totally annoying? If you sit there on Facebook and you say relationship on, relationship off, relationship on, relationship off, no one really likes that. Everyone thinks that there's something going on there. I'm not saying don't play the field and don't look around and fall in love and have a beautiful experience and make friends. I'm just saying that 40% of marriages are likely to fail if you move in together before you get married. They told me to put out statistics, so I thought I'd have some fun with some statistics for you guys and give y'all a reality check. My point with all this is that you need to find yourself. You know, I had I had an interesting life experience that I didn't really find out who I was and what I wanted to do with myself until I was in my 30s. And I didn't know, like I had no idea, man. And I'm 39, I'll be 40 this year. And I had no idea really what I wanted to do. I knew what other people wanted me to do. I knew what I was supposed to do, but I never really knew what I wanted to do. The biggest piece of advice that I can give you guys is find out who you are first. Experience what you want to experience. You know, Michael gave a great message in here in the last session. He says, if you're thinking about doing something, right before you take that nap, just don't take that nap and go do what you want to do, because when you do that, you're going to end up following your dreams and you're going to end up following some of the things that you want to do with yourself. And when you find yourself, that's really the only time that you can really love yourself and understand who you are. And once you do that, you find someone that matches up with. No one really knows who they are when they're in high school. No one really knows who they are in college. You're going to think that you know, but when it comes time to be serious and be committed about spending the rest of your life with someone, think about what you want to do with your life. Don't sit there and have the regrets of, well, if I wouldn't have married this person, I could have done this. Or if I wouldn't have done this, I could have done that. Don't have those regrets. Find yourself and then find someone else. Then find your passion, because it's going to lead you into your passion. You're going to understand that thing that you think everyone cares about, but no one really cares about. Like, I think everyone cares about technology. Not everyone cares about technology. I just think they do because it's my passion. I think everyone cares about music. No one really cares about music. I care about music, but that's my passion. Think about the thing. Like, what's something to you that's like cats, dogs, tractors, I don't know, horses. I was close with animals. What about you?
Music.
Find something that you're passionate about and figure out a way to work that into your life. Figure out a way to have fun with that. Don't let that passion die for something that you really want to do. This guy found his passion. This guy likes to cook, man. It's awesome. And look, now he's like internet famous all over the world, and everyone knows who he is. Everyone knows he's a chef. Dude, he wasn't making a mockery of himself when he did this. He's just passionate about what he does, right? And it's kind of cool because now the world knows how passionate he is, right? Boom, everybody do it. Yeah, you know you want to do it. Woo! Just like that. I found a couple things I'm passionate about. I have a local technology company called Frontera. I started this company about 4 years ago to be a technology consultant in the Rio Grande Valley. This entire building is one of my projects. It's one of my favorite projects I've ever done. My company was responsible for every bit of technology that goes into this building. From the screen, to the projectors, to the speakers, to the Wi-Fi, everything in here is a deployment of my company. And that's really cool that I get to share that with you guys. The other thing that I have his Wi-Fi stand. I decided to make a product that we put together to help serve the wireless industry. And it doesn't really mean anything to anyone that's not in the wireless industry, but you know who it does mean someone to? South by Southwest. We were officially chosen last night as one of the tech startups to be featured in their tech startup spotlight. So next week I'm gonna be presenting at South by Southwest as a featured official selection as a technology startup. That's kind of cool. But I found a passion, with it because it's something that I like, it's something that I'm doing, and I said, it's like the same as, you know, you like horses and you figure out a way to make a new horseshoe because you're passionate about horses, you think it's great, and you put it on the market. All of a sudden South by Southwest is like, hey, why don't you come show that off with all this? It's kind of a really neat deal. I also found other things that I was passionate about, music. Super, super passionate about music. When I was 14 years old, I started producing concerts in the Rio Grande Valley. And I started doing that because the music that I wanted to hear, nobody was bringing down here. And I didn't want to sit there and wait for someone else to do it. I thought, it can't be that hard. You call an artist and you say, hey, I want you to come play at my show. And then they say, I want $50,000. And you go, just kidding. So you find a friend that plays that artist's music and you book your friend for $100. You know what I mean? But you got to start somewhere. So I started Energetic Productions a bunch of years ago. The reason it's a star, I've never really told anyone why it's a star. It's from Dr. Seuss. His birthday was yesterday, right? Stars on Lars. You guys recognize the reference? No? The Sneetches? All the cool people had stars. So I made my logo a star. Anyway, because I'm cool. I don't know. But I found a passion through Energetic Productions. And what I did with that is I would produce concerts and I would charge money for people to come down. I started booking electronic music shows down here when no one had ever heard of electronic dance music. After a while, I got tired of doing it for money. There's a lot of drive when you're doing it for money and there's a lot of passion, but it becomes more of a gamble. And one day I was with my wife in Dallas and I was sitting in a park and we were watching the symphony and they were playing the 1812 overture at a Memorial Day celebration. And I looked around at all these families having a great time and I said, how come we don't have free music events in the Rio Grande Valley that are family friendly and pet friendly? Where are you going, bro? I'm just kidding. So I wanted to know why there were no events like that. Why weren't there events like that for the Rio Grande Valley? So I established the South Texas Community Arts Foundation with a friend of mine. And we're responsible for setting up events in front of the convention center, a deal called Sunset Sessions. We're responsible for producing things like the TEDx McAllen events. So we put TED together and we had a great time doing that. It was like this, but it's last 2 years ago. Yeah. Yeah, we're working on it. But we were going to do it this year, but these guys did such a great job with this, I was like, I'm not even going to, like, let them do what they're doing here, and hopefully I'll be able to recruit some of these people to help me with TED, because it's a pretty big undertaking. Eli shot it. Anyway, TED was awesome. TED was super fun, man, and oh my God, it was incredible. It was absolutely incredible. But the Community Arts Foundation produces community arts events. Through Energetic Productions, you guys have heard of You and Me? Do you know what that is? It's the largest electronic music event that happens in South Texas every year. And what's cool about it is if you look at my logo, you see that little star that's right there? The guy who produces You and Me is an old friend of mine, my old business partner. Look at that little star right there. Isn't that nice? A little reference, a little like, hey. But it's neat. And part of the reason I show that off is because me and Paul, the guy who produces the events, we've been friends for a really long time. Choose good friends. And I don't mean that in like the dad mode of be careful who you hang out with, but I do, because the people that you associate yourself with and the people that you hang out with are only gonna do one of two things. They're gonna make you better, they're gonna make you worse. That's it. If you find people that you hang out with and they start to make you worse, you need to get away from them. I'd say haters gonna hate, but that's way too cliche. You need to get away from the people that are detractors in your life, because if all they're doing is bringing you down, if they have that crab mentality of as soon as you start to do something good, they destroy it for you. Stay away from people like that. You don't need them in your life. What you need is people that are gonna help you be the best that you can be. They're gonna help you figure out whatever your dreams are and how to go after those dreams. So choose good friends, choose wisely. And the environment that you live in, you know, we talk about the Valley and about how, I think the common theme is that everyone says they hated the Valley growing up. I hated the Valley growing up. I grew up in Mercedes, man. I mean, dude. Seriously? How can you like the Valley growing up in Mercedes? We didn't even have a Whataburger. I remember when we got a Whataburger. But what I learned growing up where I did is if you don't like something, change it. Change it. Do something about it. You don't like the music that's being brought down. You don't like the concerts. Do something about it. And if you can't do something about it, then just change your attitude. don't sit there and say, oh, I hate it, it's disgusting, I can't believe this is happening. Say, you know what, it's all right, I'll find something better to do. Change your attitude. If you don't like something, change it. If you can't change it, change your attitude. This is a great painting. Gabriel is a local artist who makes these amazing paintings. And this is the valley as I remember it, right? This is what I remember growing up. Big open fields, big palm trees. Man, I feel like I'm 300 years old when I talk about it, because it really did look like that not too long ago, like in the 80s. So, which I guess is really old for you guys, but whatever. But this is how I look at it. And what's interesting is you can look at this picture in two different ways. You can look at it as big open land, or you can look at it as what people refer to as greenfield. Greenfield means opportunity, means a brand new opportunity to put something there, to do something with that field. Instead of using it for farming, use it to build a technology center out of a Kmart. What? So this building used to be a Kmart. Have you guys ever heard of Chuck Taylors? Is anyone wearing Chuck Taylors? The little Converse? Tell me someone's wearing some Converse. Right there. Those shoes, the tongue in those shoes, every single one of them used to come out of this building. Because after it was a Kmart, it was the Converse shoe factory. And they made all the uppers for Converse Chucks in this building. You know what it was after that? A ropa usada. You know what it was after that? The most technologically innovative center in South Texas. What? So you've, yeah, dude. So welcome home, little shoes. No. So that's what this represents to me. Because this is where I grew up. This is a Google Earth snapshot of the house in the Colonia that I grew up in. Except they put a vending machine. Like, who? What? That's awesome. Why didn't I think of that, man? There's a hustler that lives there. This is the house I grew up in. This is the barn that my dad built. This is the dirt road where I used to run across the street and play with all my little friends who I thought were so cool because they got to go to Iowa and Wisconsin and Michigan when they were kids, and I didn't get to go. You know what they were doing there? Migrant field workers. I thought it was so cool that they got to go stand out in the heat as child labor and get beat up because they weren't picking fast enough. What did I know, you know? My whole thing that everyone in the neighborhood thought I was so cool for was right inside this door. It was a bathroom because my house was the only one on that road that had indoor plumbing. Everyone else had outhouses. Perspective, man, right? Like you grow up and you're like, dude, that's nuts. So that's where I grew up and this is where I live now. No, just kidding. Oh. That's a cool house though. Obviously, it's in Rio Grande City. Hello. But that's, yeah, I would love to live there. I would love to live there because this really is where I grew up, unlike that other picture. And I learned that you do have to change your perspective and you have to change your environment. And you can only do that if you're around the right people. And you can only be around the right people if you know who you are and you know what you want and you know what you want to be. That's what leads it all into each other. Because this is your typical half empty, half full. You can look at the Rio Grande Valley and say it's half empty. And I can look at the Rio Grande Valley and say it's half full. And it's up to you what your perspective is. It's up to you if you want to make the valley half empty or half full, but it's up to you what you want to do with it.
Change the cup.
Change the cup. You can change the cup. In the great words of Nas, if you don't start something, there won't be nothing. Anyway, 97, what are you going to do? If you want something to happen, you have to do something about it. And you have to find your voice. You have to be able to articulate. You have to be able to talk about what it is that you want and what you want to do. You can't just sit there and say that you want to do something and not know how to articulate that to someone. The English language, the Spanish language, the German language, any language that you choose, master it. Don't say like every other sentence. Don't stall and go, figure out how to use your words, because your words are your power. Your voice is your power. It helps you contribute globally and locally to do the things that you want to do. To be the instrument of change, globally or locally, you have to have a voice. I started a Twitter account called Wireless Nerd a bunch of years ago because I'm in the technology industry and I would go to these technology trade shows. And I knew a lot of the vendors, and I would want to say bad things about their products behind their back, like, this thing totally sucks, like, that microphone's terrible, it doesn't really work. It does, I'm just kidding. But I would want, AV guys staring at me. But I wanted to say things like that because I wanted to have an unbiased opinion about technology that I saw in the marketplace. So I started the Wireless Nerd account to be this little shadow. And the Wireless Nerd account got a lot of attention. 1,000 users, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 followers. People paying attention to what I was saying. I had this guy come up to me one day and told me, start a blog, Drew. And I said, you're an idiot, no one blogs. And he says, start a blog. He said, your blog is your voice. And if you have an opinion about something, put it online. 155,000 page views later in a year, whatever it's been. This is from yesterday or 2 days ago. 9,000 page views in the last month. My blog's been syndicated by some of the largest technology magazines that are out there in the industry because I just took the time to write down things that I thought were important to me. Building a case for community connectivity. LTE, sensors and beacons. Google gets knee deep in something. Things that I thought, man, I'm gonna write something about this. I'm gonna use my words. I'm gonna use my voice so that I can have something to say and I'm gonna post it online. And people picked it up. They picked it up so much that now I'm a part of this large organization in technology. This is 3 days ago, sitting on a panel with the top wireless industry experts in Nashville, Tennessee. These are the top eight people that are industry writers. These are top eight people that are industry associates. You guys have heard of HP, Hewlett Packard, they make computers? This is the CTO and the executive VP. This is Thursday. This is me, at least I changed shirts. This is me standing right beside him because I had a one-on-one opportunity with them. I got to sit there across the table from these people that make huge decisions about technology and tell them, hey man, you know what? The interface is all weird. You should totally change the colors on it. Or hey, you should do this. Or hey, you know, change the way that this is an interaction. I got the opportunity to have a one-on-one session with them. And I get this fairly frequently because I decided to use my voice. I decided to use my words. I decided to start writing. Not everyone's a writer, but you don't have to be a writer. You have to master the English language, right? At least master the English language or the Spanish language. I don't care. Whichever one you master, be good at it. Articulate. Know, have a large... What's the word that I'm looking for, you know? Yes, vernacular, yes. So learn, yeah, I'm here telling you. Do as I say, not as I do, children. No, but you know what I mean? Like, learn how to use it so that way people appreciate you and they understand you better. Nothing is as good as a concise statement. So one of the things I did is I started CodeRGV with a couple friends of mine. Have you guys heard of CodeRGV? Okay, so CodeRGV is a 501c educational nonprofit. We're based here in this building and we teach people computer science. We teach them how to program. We teach them about robotics. We teach them about drones. We teach them about VR. We have free sessions every Saturday at the McAllen Public Library. We have free sessions on Saturdays here. We have a twice a month meetup where nerds just get together and be nerds and we hang out. And we have all these programs where we have boot camps where after you're done with university, you can go through one of our boot camps and we can take you from not having a job to making a $75,000 a year job that happens in this building. We have Tech Tuesdays where we bring in people from all over the technology industry in the Rio Grande Valley and we have them set up shop and talk about what they do. We have Code Camp where everyone comes together and we learn about robotics and drones and stuff like that. Super, super fun. And then the Academy, when you all are old enough to drink, we have free pizza and beer. You don't have to drink beer, we have free Coke too. But that happens twice a month and people get together and they learn stuff. Like, what's something you know about computer-wise, technology-wise? Pick something.
Google,
great. So what's something you know? Huh?
A little bit of coding.
A little bit of coding. So you know how to work with Google, you know coding. Do you know how to use the G Suite of applications? No, but he might. And maybe he wants to learn how to code. So when you show up and you talk about coding, he learns how to code and you learn about the G Suite. And now you guys have become better nerds. That's what we do. Huh? That you just show up. Nedra's there every single time. Nedra doesn't want to be a computer programmer, but Nedra's learned all kinds of stuff that now makes her able to hold a conversation about technology. You can learn all kinds of stuff. Man, we did like a wireless hacking session one day where I broke in everyone's phones at the same time. It was super awesome. Seriously, and it's a lot of fun. And it's not that I show you how to do that, it's that I show you where your vulnerabilities are so that you know how to protect yourself from things like that. The point with that is find a challenge. CodeRGV for me is a challenge. It's a challenge to get away from my work. It's a challenge to get away from my family. It's a challenge to find time to dedicate to doing it. But if I find a challenge that's something that I'm passionate about, it's always gonna continuously make me better. if you're not challenging yourself every day, you're never really gonna be at your full potential. Always do what you're afraid to do. Always. If it's scary, it's good. You know, I mean, in most cases, like, listen to your parents, you know, but but if it's something that you're unsure of, if it's something that you're going, man, if I don't know if I can do this, God, I don't know if I can do it. Oh my God, my wife is smoking gorgeous. She's so beautiful. Like, she is so beautiful. And I don't just mean that because she's my wife. Like, she's really hot. She's super great. And the thing about her is she was totally out of my league. Like, totally out of my league. I went for it anyway. And every day I wake up and I'm like, yeah. I was a little nervous, but dude, I did it. Always do what you're afraid to do because the payoff is huge. Everything that you do matters. Everything. What you write, what you say, what you post online, the selfie that you posted. Everything that you do matters. The way that you talk, the way that you walk, the way that you act, it all matters. Everything you do matters. I did a presentation one time at UTRGV. How many? I've got like 5 minutes, right? Three? So, I don't know. I'm checking. So, I did a presentation one time at UTRGV, and I got real. Like, I got real with the crowd. And it was like scary real, but it was necessary, right? If you decide to get a tattoo on your neck, I'm not gonna hire you. I'm not saying that that's because I don't appreciate your artistic abilities and like how you're expressing yourself through tattoo work on your neck. Dude, I'm not gonna hire you because I can't send you into a corporate client with a tattoo on your neck. If you don't know how to shave, if you don't know how to dress, if you don't know how to carry yourself, if you don't know how to politely respond to people, if you don't know that you're not supposed to put elbows on the table when you're eating, I'm not gonna hire you. Things like that matter. Every single thing matters. And in the Valley, we're pretty laid back. But in the rest of the world, everything matters. Girls, ladies, you guys have it rough. And you do have it rough. That's the truth. Everyone will be so much harder on you, at least in the technology industry, than they will on the guys. You gotta own it. Like, you gotta own it. You know, and it sucks. It's not fair. But it matters. It matters that you're a female. So instead of going in there with a defeatist attitude, you walk in like, yeah, I'm a female and I can do your job. What? You go in there, own it. Everything that you do matters. Every text message you send, every email that you send, everything you post on Facebook. Dude, I could go for days and talk about the security work that we do. Everyone has access to everything. Don't ever write something down that you're ever gonna regret. Don't ever send a picture you're gonna regret. Don't ever say something, even if it's on Snapchat or whatever, that you think is gonna magically disappear. That stuff does not disappear. It doesn't, and it will come back to haunt you. Everything matters. Everything that every adult has ever told you matters. I'm not saying listen to your parents and listen to your adults, but seriously, it does matter. And I had this weird realization where I didn't think any of that stuff mattered until I owned my own business. And then I started looking at employees who would come in, and I go, I don't know if I want that person representing me. Not for, you know, not for any huge reasons, but just like little things. So everything that you do in your life matters. So don't do dumb stuff. You guys are here, which is tremendous. You're choosing to spend your Saturday here instead of doing other things. You're here learning. You're here making yourself a better person. Don't do dumb stuff. If it's dumb, you know it's dumb. You know it's dumb. And you're like, I'm gonna do it anyway. You know, I do it all the time. I'm an adult. No, but try not to do dumb stuff, right? God, I love this. It's one of my favorite. No regrets. No, not even one letter. No regrets. Learn how to spell. Like, if you're gonna get a tattoo, learn how to spell. You know? Don't do dumb stuff. Don't do dumb stuff. Vote. It's really, really, really important. Vote. Calm down, marketing. Make sure you vote. It's absolutely important. I don't care who you vote for. I don't care why you vote for them. I don't care what your politics are and what you post on Facebook about this and that and whatever. I don't care, just vote. When it comes down to you standing in front of the machine, know that you're making the country a better country because of what you're doing. How many of you are legal voters right now? No feral people, put your hands down. Did you guys vote?
Well, we just became
Fair enough. Go vote. Go vote. It takes like that long. And then you get to do the selfie with the little sticker that says, I voted. Totally do that. All in all, that, I mean, that's, I don't have like some big slide to finish off other than that. That was kind of funny. You mad, bro? Yes, I'm mad. Anyway, the whole point of what I wanted to talk to you guys about is that where we are in the Rio Grande Valley isn't a terrible place, but it's up to you to make it a great place. And you do that by thinking backwards about this slide deck. Don't do dumb stuff. Choose your friends wisely. Find your voice. Find your passion. Your passion is going to lead you to your voice. Your voice is going to lead you to your success. Your success is what's going to keep people enthusiastic about being around you. If you do dumb stuff, it negates all of that. You do a couple of bad things and it can destroy your entire life. It can destroy your career. It can destroy your social life. It can do a bunch. There's a lot of bad things that can happen. So try and avoid the potholes that are out there. But at the same time, be willing to live in a way that is challenging to you and challenging to everyone around you. So that's all I got. I appreciate your time.